Hello, and welcome back to Tea with Tracy, coming to you live every Tuesday at 12, spilling relevant tips, trends, and talk in all things real estate and home ownership related. Today, we're kicking off a new series. It's a community services series featuring some of the local community services available to Lake Orion residents and the surrounding areas. To kick off the series, I have Joe Johnson, studio manager for ONTV, joining me. As you have noticed, and I have mentioned, I am actually coming to you live from the ONTV podcast studio each week. So as well, there's those services as well as many others that ONTV provides to the community, and we'll get Joe on to join us and talk about those. Hi, Joe.
Hi, Tracy. How are you?
Great. How are you?
I'm fantastic.
Good. Thank you so much for joining us today. I know you are over in one of the other studios that is available within ONTV, and I'm in the podcast studio, so we're actually in the same building.
That's right.
So thank you for joining us and talking to us a little bit today. I want to let viewers know, you know, what is ONTV and what does ONTV provide to the community? For those who may not already know.
People may have heard the expression public access television. That's what we are. We give the community access to our equipment and facilities to produce their own programs, podcasts, whatever they want to do. We are a nonprofit organization funded by the township and village, but not with tax dollars. We're funded by cable revenues. So those who have cable TV here in the Orion area help fund us and allow us to do what we do.
Okay. And how long has ONTV been around? How long has it been serving the community?
We've been serving the community in one form or another over the past 30 years. We just recently had our 30th anniversary. We initially, it's a little complicated at the beginning. Public access was originally provided by the cable company, and ONTV used to be OCTV, excuse me, and they kind of oversaw what the cable company was providing to the community. But in 2000, those contracts came to an end, and ONTV took over public access and formed a nonprofit organization. So we've existed as ONTV since the year 2000.
Okay, so it's been decades now that you've been ONTV and OCTV and serving the community. And I know, you know, having three kids that have gone through and are going through the school, you know, the Lake Orion schools, we see you at some of the sporting events and
right.
See you at community events. And so for those who can't make it or want to watch a replay, you provide the access for that. School board meetings. What are some of the other things that you cover?
Well, I'd like to say the gem on our channel is our newscast. We do a newscast on a regular basis, not daily, but probably about every 2 weeks on average, we do a newscast. For that newscast, you usually see me out in the community covering fundraisers, events, parades, you name it, ribbon cutting ceremonies from the Chamber of Commerce. We go out there, we cover those community events and put that all together for a newscast that airs on a regular basis here. I jokingly call our newscast the Good News Newscast because we want to focus on the positive here in Lake Orion, the good things that are happening.
Absolutely. And there are so many good things that are happening. And that's why this is a great fit, because that's what I like to do on my podcast is provide information, you know, the positive side of things. And it was really great. I actually recently learned that the studios here were available to residents if you wanted to, you know, use them. You provide classes, right, for those that are interested in learning more?
Correct. The prerequisite to get access to this facility is to take our classes. We offer a 10-week video production workshop that includes instruction here in the studio, editing, and you can also check out portable cameras that we make available. You can check them out like a library book. But to get access to all of our equipment and facilities, you have to take our 10-week video production workshop. Our new round of classes is coming back after our little shutdown over the last 18 months. And we have about a dozen people go through our classes as a group. They learn every aspect of video production, and when that class comes to an end, All of this is theirs to use to create their own programs.
Well, I will say that I didn't do the 10-week class, but I did the podcast class. I'm interested in that 10-week class, but it has been a lot of fun learning how to use the equipment and, you know, coming and producing from an actual studio as opposed to just, you know, doing it from my camera and at home. So,
yeah, and, you know, we have a lot of success stories here. I remember a few years ago we were doing a 10-week workshop for the seniors. We share the Orient Center with the Senior Center. So we did a class just for the seniors. And I remember in the first week of that class, one of our seniors saw all of this technology and said, I don't know if this is for me. And I said, well, stick through it and, you know, stick with it and go through it and have fun with your friends. And by the end of the 10-week workshop, she just absolutely loved it. And now she directs programs and produces programs. And she's even been named our Volunteer of the Year.
Wow.
So we're really proud of that success story. So we invite people, you don't need any experience ahead of time to come in, take those classes, and start producing your own program.
That's fantastic. So if you are out there and if you have ever had a thought or a passion that has anything to do with television or podcast or some sort of production, Owen TV, contact them. Sign up for the class and you can learn and you really explore and see if there's something more that you want to do with it. Or even if you just want to take the class, right? That's okay to just take the class and...
Oh, sure. If you just want to sharpen your skills, a lot of people now have access to editing software and things you can do right out of your own home. A lot of people are setting up podcast recording facilities in their own home. So we'll offer you the training. And if you want to produce from home, you can do that as well. And another exciting event we have coming up in a couple of months is the return to our live film festival. We've been doing that for about 6 or 7 years, and a lot of high school students get involved. Adults are invited as well. And we have like 48 hours or so where we challenge producers to go out into the community, shoot a film in 48 hours, wow, turn it into us. We have judges look at it, and the big finale is we show all the movies at the Oxford 7 Theater and hand out awards, and there's a live audience watching your film on the big screen. It's really
wow,
exciting. And you don't have to take our classes to take part in that. That's open to anyone in the community who wants to produce a short film.
Okay. So when is that coming up? Like, what does somebody have to do?
That's
if they're
in October.
Interested?
That's going to be okay, about mid-October. So okay, reach out to us prior to that, and we'll start putting together a list of teams that want to take part.
That sounds fantastic. Actually, I have somebody in mind that just popped up that I'm going to make sure that they are aware of that, because that sounds like a lot of fun.
Oh, it really is. It's one of our most popular events we do.
Oh, that's fantastic. So what else? Is there anything else that we should know about ONTV?
Well, we do have a production truck that we send out to cover community events. We use that. You mentioned earlier high school football. I'm really excited about high school football rolling around again.
Yes.
We do concerts at Wildwood and in the gazebo and Children's Park. We cover a wide variety of things with our portable truck. So that's a lot of fun, too. If you have a child that's in a dance recital or something like that, we can roll out our truck to record a dance recital. Of course, we use that to cover the graduation every year, which is one of our biggest days of the year. We're so glad that this year they returned to their traditional
yes,
graduation at DTE. We can roll that out for an event that you want covered as well. So come to us, approach us, and we'll do whatever we can to help you make your dreams come true.
That's awesome. And I can just say, just in my, the few months that I've been coming here and working with you and working with the others at ONTV, it's been fantastic. Everybody is always so eager to help and come up with new ways to do things. And it's really been a lot of fun and a great experience. So I would encourage you, if you have any interest in, anything that has to do with television or production or podcasts, just call ONTV, and I'm sure someone, Tracy probably at the front desk, or someone
That's
will be
right,
happy to direct you in the right, put you in the right touch with the right person to be able to get started. So
yep, so we're located in the Orient Center on Joslyn Road, right next to the elementary school. You can give us a call, 248-393-1060. or visit our website, OrionOnTV.org. On our website, you could watch our channel streaming live. We also, I don't want to neglect mention this, we also archive all the meetings that we do, village council meetings, planning, zoning, township board meetings. All of those are recorded and archived. So if you don't watch them live as they air, you can go to our website and watch them on demand.
That's fantastic. And yeah, so you have the channel on the cable station, you have your website, as well as many of your videos, if not all, go onto your YouTube channel. So there are so many different avenues that you can, if there's something you want to view or find, it's there.
Yeah, and look us up on social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, all of that.
Fantastic. Yeah, be sure to follow OrionOnTV on both Instagram, and you can find them on Facebook as well. And you'll get some, if you're interested, notifications of when they go live of different events and different videos as they are posted. So
yeah, and if you know of anything happening in the community, reach out to us. Be happy to show up with the camera in hand. We got a call out of the blue last year that a resident was celebrating his 100th birthday. And I will show up with a camera to cover something like that.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's awesome. You are. I'm sure everybody who's watching this that's a part of the community recognizes your face. Joe Johnson, he's always there with a smile and you know, taking care of our community. So thank you.
I'm happy to do it, and I love what I do.
It shows. It definitely shines through. So
thanks.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Joe. Thanks for representing ONTV. Thank you all for tuning in. And if you want any additional information or if you have some suggestions for ONTV, feel free to give them a call. Check them out on their website. But if you're not accessing this community gem, you're missing out. You really need to explore and see what they have to offer. So, well,
thanks for having me, and thanks for helping spread the word.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Thanks so much, Joe. Thank you all. We'll see you next Tuesday on Tea with Tracy.